and welcome to Value TV. October is a milestone month for us. Just 5 years ago, we brought you the first episode, and through prayer and perseverance, you are now watching our 60th show. Perseverance is often required in severe circumstances. The secret ingredient to get through your situation is faith. What are you dealing with that requires you to persevere?
Hi, my name is Joseph Steen, and I am thrilled to be making my directorial debut with Christmas Bells. Christmas Bells is the sequel to last season's comedy smash hit, Dearly Beloved, which centers around the Futrell sisters, Frankie, Twink, and Honey Ray. It's Christmas time in Faro, Texas, and a very pregnant Frankie is 2 weeks overdue with her second set of twins. Jilted Twink is in jail for inadvertently burning down half the town, and hot flash suffering Honey Ray is directing the Tabernacle of the Lamb's Christmas Eve program. The sisters band together in true Futrell fashion to bring a show that the people of Faro and Florence will never forget.
It's time to get in the Christmas spirit with lots of laughter. See what the crazy Futrell sisters have been up to since last season's Dearly Beloved. This hilarious holiday sequel is sure to bring joy to your world. A special thank you to our underwriters, First Reliance Bank and Hilliard Lions. Tickets go on sale November 5th. Call the box office at 662-3731 for more information.
You're thinking about going to college, and there are a lot of great choices. But consider the cost. Your freshman and sophomore years at a private university or proprietary college could cost you more than $37,000. A public university, more than $20,000. At Florence Darlington Technical College, less than $7,600. That's right, only $7,600 for 2 years at FDTC. The numbers speak for themselves. Get started at fdtc.edu, keyword cost. Parents, you do the math.
Hello, my name is Melody Adams. I'm the Marketing and Sales Director for the Presbyterian Community here in Florence. I hope you enjoyed your tour today. If you'd like your own personalized tour, please call 665-2222 to schedule your visit today. Presbyterian Community, enriching the lives of seniors of all faiths.
Congratulations to Florence School District 1's 2014-15 Teacher of the Year, Lindsay Bibler of South Florence High School.
In August of 93, I was 7 years old and I attended Greenwood Elementary School. While I was there, my teacher asked us to create a book about us. In that book, we had to have a page about what we wanted to be when we grow up. So I wrote, "When I grow up, I want to be a teacher." Because teachers can help you read, write, and learn. And they can help you with more stuff than that. That's what I want to be when I grow up. I teach seniors and juniors AP Calculus, and when they come back to me after a semester of college and say, wow, math was so easy, I was the only kid in class who knew the answer, that is evidence to me that I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing in my job.
On October 17th, we're bringing back Healthy Woman Downtown, an exclusive event for men and women to benefit the American Cancer Society. The doors open at 7 p.m. at the IS Rainwater Building at 142 North Dargan Street in Florence's historic downtown district. Watch some guys and gals walk the runway for Healthy Woman's annual fashion show featuring boutique trends. Then put on your dancing shoes and get ready to have fun with an awesome band. So come enjoy a night on the town while supporting a great cause. Go get your tickets, and when you do, you'll be entered for a grand prize. You can get them online at carolinashospital.com/healthywoman. Then look on the right-hand side under Community Topics and click on Healthy Woman Events and look for the downtown event. You can also call 674-2615. Hope to see you there. Friends, family, survivors, and supporters, put on your walking shoes for a good cause and come out to Carolina's Hospital System's Walk for Life, Race for Life to benefit Susan G. Komen for the Cure. The event is Saturday, October 25th at the BB&T Amphitheater outside of the FMU Performing Arts Center. Registration opens at 7:15 in the morning. Then your little one can come out at 8:15 for Kids for a Cure Dash completely for free. And the walk/race starts at 8:30 in the morning. Day of registration is $15, or register now for only $10. Just go to carolinashospital.com/healthywoman and look on the right-hand side and click on Healthy Woman Events, then sign up. By the end of 2014, it's estimated that there will be close to 300,000 new cases of breast cancer. So come out and help find a cure.
Have you always wanted to go back to school, but life keeps getting in the way? Florence Darlington Technical College now offers weekend college. Invest in yourself. Take advantage of the convenience, flexibility, and most of all, affordability of weekend college. Is it the right time for you? It is a personal decision to return to school. The excitement of a new career, an increase in personal income, or professional advancement are great motivators. Earn credits toward an Associate in Arts degree on Fridays and Saturdays. Classes provide interaction with your instructor and fellow students with additional online coursework to fit your schedule. All classes are transferable and financial aid is available. For more information, call the admissions office at 843-661-8051 or visit fdtc.edu. That's 843-661-8051. What are you waiting for?
Hi, I'm Officer Merchant from the Florence Police Department.
I'm Officer Hubble with the Florence Police Department. I love working for the City of Florence Police Department. It gives me a chance to serve my community. Working patrol, I've been with the police department for 5 years. I interact with the community and I know a lot of people in our community. I love getting the chance to help people and get people out of bad situations. It gives me a chance to drive them in the right direction in life.
Working for the City of Florence Police Department, I've learned a lot of skills to help me to develop further in life as far as honesty, integrity, and community-oriented skills. Helping the community is one of the best parts of my job. Being there in people's time of need when nobody else is there to help them. You're always one running towards the danger when they need you.
Being a police officer is not all about putting people in jail. It's about creating a safer environment for the citizens of the City of Florence. It's about creating an environment where criminals don't want to exist.
What made me want to join the Florence Police Department was the freedom of being out here with the community and the public. At this job, you're called to be an electrician, a mechanic, or a plumber. You're whatever people need when they call you, and you have to just be there in their time of need.
Hi, I'm Alan Hyde, the police chief for the City of Florence. Working in a team environment is part of the City of Florence. The police department focuses on effective law enforcement by building lasting community partnerships. If you're interested in law enforcement as a career and you have a strong sense of community, then we invite you to submit your application and become a part of the City of Florence team.
The Rehab Center at Morrill, located in Hartsville, South Carolina, is a 56-bed inpatient short-term rehab facility. At Morrill, we realize that each patient is anxious to regain mobility so they can return to their homes. Through patient-centered and goal-oriented rehabilitation care, the certified staff at Morrill work hard to help patients reach their maximum potential. The center just completed several renovation and expansion projects. One of those is a new canopy entrance, allowing patients and visitors access to the center with ease and convenience. In addition, the facility has four newly constructed patient suites, which include spacious rooms with attached baths. Due to the continued growth of the rehab center, one of the most anticipated projects was the expansion of the gym. The finished product is three times the size of the former gym and is home to physical, occupational, and speech therapy. The gym contains state-of-the-art equipment accompanied by a bright color scheme chosen to uplift, motivate, and energize the patients during therapy. Last but certainly not least is the Courtyard Cafe at Morrill. This exclusive area was designed so that rehab patients and their family members can have a designated dining and lounge area. The contemporary design and furnishings in the cafe create a relaxing atmosphere for rehab patients in between therapy sessions. The cafe is complete with Wi-Fi, allowing patients to stay connected with the outside community during their short-term stay. The Rehab Center at Morrill cares for a range of conditions: osteoporosis, neurological disorders, orthopedic injuries, muscle imbalance, post-surgical, arthritis, amputees, generalized weakness, and more. Let our qualified staff get you back on your feet again and on the road to recovery. Call us today at 843-332-3080.
Hello, my name is Dale Cook, and I want to introduce you to the networking program at the Florence Career Center, and specifically the cybersecurity competitions that we compete in as part of the networking program. Any students that's in the 10th through 12th grade are eligible to take the networking program at the Florence Career Center and are eligible to compete in the cybersecurity competitions. The goal of the cybersecurity competitions that we compete in is to, one, to teach the students these cybersecurity skills, so that they can use them at home or in their future workplaces. And a second important goal is to excite them and motivate them to go off to college and take something in the science, technology, engineering, and math field, and specifically cybersecurity. The benefits to the students in these competitions, which we compete in three, are just phenomenal. It's real world experience. It's the same thing that people in the IT field are facing on a daily basis. So basically, they get a computer that has some problems with it, and during a 6 or 8 hour competition, they work to solve those problems just like people in the work world would. We participate in Cyber Patriot, which is the National High School Cyber Defense Competition. In 2013, we won the Open Division of Cyber Patriot within the state of South Carolina.
I kind of just wanted to learn more about network security and possibly get a job in that field.
The thing I enjoy most is working with people and the realism of it, and actually identifying problems like I was actually working for a business. So when I go into a business, I'll actually have some experience.
My favorite part of the program is actually getting out there and meeting other IT people and learning things from them.
For any student or parent interested in IT or technology or networking or cybersecurity, you just need to reach out to your local high school at the guidance counselors, and they can tell you more about the networking program and the cybersecurity program.
Hey, this is Tammy Clark with the Savvy Mag of Florence, wanting to remind you to take advantage of our savings every month from your local businesses. And now we'd like to announce we have a mobile app. you can download on your iPhone or your Android. Savings from your local businesses at your fingertips. Thank you, PD, for your continued support.
Hello, I'm Tim Norwood, owner of Victor's, and you might notice a slight change in our name. We've been historically known as Victor's Bistro, and recently we dropped the Bistro, and we're now known as Victor's Steaks, Wine, and Seafood. And the reason we dropped Bistro is that Bistro connotates a certain kind of food that people are looking when they come to a Bistro. And we had gotten away from the Bistro food, and so we're focusing more now on having the best steaks that you can possibly get anywhere in the country. And then the best wine list that's available. We'll be in a Wine Spectator designated restaurant later this year. And then our seafood, which is the freshest, best seafood you can get. So those are the things we're focusing on. Cooper Thomas, who's our new general manager, he's developed a brand new menu focused around Victor's steaks, wine, and seafood.
I wanted to say thanks to everyone for the overwhelming response that we got from our tasting last month. I want to thank everybody for the support. Our new menu is going quite well and seems to be well received. Tis the season for college football. If you're looking to do tailgate parties or you have holiday parties coming up in the next month or so, please think of Victor's. We would love to come to you, or we have plenty of banquet space here for you to rent. And even if you're not looking to do a tailgate event and you just want to enjoy watching the game, come on up to Victor's. We have 3 flat screen TVs and a wonderful atmosphere in our lounge area. And don't forget, we're open for breakfast, lunch, and dinner 7 days a week. Hope to see you here soon.
We'd like to invite you to come out. Our patio is, I think, is the best outside dining experience in Florence. We're open, you know, every evening, and the weather's cooling down. We got the umbrella up. We got the lights on the umbrella. You're gonna feel like you're in Europe, maybe Italy or France, sitting outside on the patio. And we'll serve a bar menu, outside menu, or a regular menu. We have live entertainment every Thursday and Friday night, and so I think it'll be a lot of fun, so come on down and join us.
Florence Darlington Technical College is celebrating its golden anniversary with a 50th year celebration Saturday night, November 8th at the College's Southeastern Institute of Manufacturing and Technology, with a look to the glorious past and to the shining future. FDTC opened in 1964 as Florence Darlington Technical Education Center and was known as Tech. Now a degree-granting college, the community still calls it Tech. FDTC has grown from 200 students to over 6,000 today. Happy birthday, Florence Darlington Technical College.
Hi, I'm Happy Pendergraft, and we're here at King Cadillac, and we're here to talk about Habitat for Humanity and the Restore. I have with me Miss McDougall, and she is running the Restore. And Ms. McDougall, can you tell us, what is the Restore all about?
The Restore is the Habitat's money-generating facility that helps make money to build homes in Florence County. Everything we make at the Restore stays right here in Florence County to build homes and fulfill our mission. Items are donated. Once they're donated, they're put on the floor to sell, and because we build homes, most of the items have something to do with the house, whether it's building material, furniture, household needs, or even clothing.
And I take it that these items that you sell at the Restore are at a very reduced price?
They are at a wonderful price. We have wonderful donors who bring in beautiful items, and we sell them at a wonderful price so everybody can afford it.
How do people with big items get them to the Restore?
We have a truck that picks up the items. They call our number, which is 843-292-0570. We schedule a pickup, and they will be given a tax receipt when the item is picked up. We are located at 612 South Irby Street if they'd like to drop off the item.
But Besides donations, is there anything that the community can help you with?
Yes, we always need volunteers. Volunteers make nonprofits profitable. Also, they can join us on Facebook. Once they join us on Facebook, we have daily updates about our needs, our sales, and what's going on at the build, so we can always be found on Facebook.
Thank you so much for coming in. It's been a pleasure working with Habitat for Humanity and the Restore.
Thank you, King Cadillac, for making us your Charity of the Month. We appreciate it.
My name is Darlene Richardson. I have been affiliated with AccuStaff for over 20 years. I am an administrative assistant. I like AccuStaff because they are able to better match my skill set and expertise with local employers. With each assignment, I gain more and more experience. I'm able to develop my skills. One major advantage for working for AccuStaff is they've been able to perfectly match my skill set and expertise with Fortune 500 companies, and provide me with opportunities to excel and grow with each assignment. Another major advantage of AccuStaff is I get a higher rate of pay. I tend to get a higher rate of pay with them. And their benefits, I don't have a waiting period. I was able to sign up for benefits right away. The staff at AccuStaff are professional, easy to get in touch with. Anytime I have questions or concerns, I can always pick up the phone and call, send them an email, even send them a text message. I like AccuStaff for those reasons especially. They don't leave you hanging out there. I would recommend AccuStaff to anyone who's seeking employment in the area and hoping to get ahead.
Hi, I'm Doris Lockhart. You've met Darlene Richardson. She is the caliber of talent that we provide to our clients. If you are a local business that is seeking talent, please remember the AccuStaff advantage.
Hey there, I'm Jeannie Bollinger, and I'm going to talk to you today about perseverance and how it's been a big word in my life, especially over the past 3 months. A year ago, I started feeling called to adopt, which is crazy because I've never had that desire. And so I started praying about it, and God just was like, be aware. I just want you to be aware of, you know, the orphan crisis in our world. And so then I changed my prayers as he spoke to me. And so then I was like, okay, well, make me aware, give me an opportunity. And in January, I was on Facebook one day and saw a post of a friend, and she said she was going on a mission trip and they wanted some more people to go. And the second I clicked on it and saw it was to visit orphans in Ethiopia, I just started bawling, crying. And so then I began the process of raising money and, you know, praying for my heart to be prepared for the yucky stuff and the challenges that I would face on that trip. I went on that trip in June, and it was life-changing. It was amazing, and I do still feel called to adopt, but I also feel like I can do more now. I can affect more than just one life or two lives. And then when I got home from my trip, then my life here at home kind of just became a mess, and I guess I always thought that that mission trip would be more to serve others and to help other people. I didn't realize that God was gonna use it to prepare me for what would lay ahead, you know, in the near future. In July, my husband lost his job, so that was a real test for our faith and for our marriage. And I will say it strengthened us more than anything else could have. And I mean, that was another prayer of mine for my relationship. I mean, my marriage to be strengthened. And then 2 weeks after that, got an opportunity to be a second grade teacher. And even though it was literally the week before school started, I was excited that I would be able to sweep in and provide for my family while we were going through a downtime. So it was just beautiful to see how God met us where we were and was able to give us the strength we needed for that time. But we know that there's a reason for it all, because it makes us more like Christ. And how can we know him if we don't suffer at least a small way as he suffered for us. Thank you for listening.
When I think of Glenn Willis, I think of constituent service. I think of honesty. I think of financial conservatism. I think of somebody that cares about the community and what the community is all about. I think of Glenn, and I think of somebody that works harder than any three other councilmen because he believes in helping people. And most of all, when I think of Glenn Willis, I think of my friend.
I first met Councilman Glenn Willis when I was in office as a veteran service officer. And Glenn was working on a project for a veteran that really needed his help. And he was relentless at assisting this veteran. And I really appreciated his support. From that time on, I continued to watch Glenn as he served in the community. Glenn is a great person of service. Currently, he serves on the Widows of Deceased Veterans Foundation Board, assisting widows who need help. Support Glenn Willis on November the 4th when you vote.
The City of Florence has been extremely fortunate to have a person of Glenn Willis's caliber serving on City Council the last 4 years. He is a public servant in the truest sense of the term. Glenn is always willing to help the citizens of Florence with any problems or concerns they may have. He always tries to answer their questions or seek a solution to their problem. Glenn's only goal is helping the citizens of Florence, and that is why he has my vote.
In deciding how to vote, I do my homework, find out about the person, and then make the choice. In the city council race, Glenn Willis, the incumbent, gets my vote. Why? Because he does his homework before saying what he's going to do. And what he says he's going to do is always the common sense and right thing to do. He did this on the Planning Commission and other public service opportunities. The citizens of Florence know Glenn as a man of character, a man they can depend on, and a man who gets the job done. Glenn will be the first to tell you the job's not complete. His vision is for a lot more to be accomplished. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. And this seat ain't broke. I'm voting for Glenn Willis.
It is an honor and privilege to serve you on City Council. Time is ticking to the November 4th general election. I'm not finished yet, and I need your vote.
Don't give up. We are all being tested. Look at your situation as a chance to glorify God through your trials. And know that He is with you in whatever you are dealing with. Find comfort in knowing that your salvation is the ultimate reward for perseverance. Remember.
And I am sure of this, that He who began a good work in you will bring it to completion at the day of Jesus Christ. Philippians 1-6. Happy 60th episode.